Hello people, this is SelfTurts and in this video we'll learn what is local repository and what is remote repository in Git. So if you are a software developer, then you must know about some version control system, and Git is the best version control system nowadays. So you must learn Git if you don't know about it, and in this video we'll learn the important concept of local repository and remote repository in Git. So what is a repository? A repository is a place where files and folders are stored. So basically, when you create a new software or web app or something like that, then you create some files and folders where you write your code. So when you combine these files and folder and put it inside a particular project, that project is called repository. And that repository can be a Git repository too, if we attach or if we link that particular folder to Git. We'll see how to create Git repository. So what is repository? Repository is a place where files and folders are stored. Now what is local repository? So as the name suggests, local means local to you, which means when the repository is present inside your laptop or your PC, then it is a local repository, which means when the files and folders are present inside your laptop or PC, which is a Git repository, means these files and folders which are stored in your local system as Git repository, then that particular repository is called local repository. And what is remote repository? So when the files and folders are stored in some remote location on some server, then it is called remote repository. Now the most famous ones are GitHub, which you must have seen. If you have used some libraries, open source library, then you must have gone to this site to download or to clone those repositories. So GitHub is an important place where you can create your own repositories of Git, which are remote. Same way, Bitbucket is new in the market, and this also allows users to create their own repositories. So you don't need to be create your repositories remotely only. You can create Git servers on your local system. So Git software allows you to create Git server on your local system, which can be on your laptop or PC or some other server where you can host your Git server, and there you can create your remote repositories. And then what happens? This local repositories and this remote repository is connected to each other. So the local repository has the same file which is present in the remote repositories, which means the local repository is exact replica of the remote repository. The files which are present on this remote system is same as the file which are present in the local repository. Now you work in your local repositories and push your work to the remote repository. So you are working on your local repository, you are doing some changes to the file, you are creating new features, you are writing new code, you are solving bugs, and what then you do? Then you save those changes to this local repository, and then you push or you send those changes to the remote repository. So why this is important? Why this local repository and remote repository are connected, and you need to make some changes, save it, and then push to the remote repository? Because when you work on a project, then when you work on a project in a company, then you are not the only person you are working. Other people are also there which are working on it. So there may be developer 1, developer 2, and developer 3, and they all are working on a single project, and the local version of that project is present on developer 1 system, developer 2 system, and developer 3 system. So those local files and folders is known as what? Local repositories, and there is a single remote repository. So the local repository of developer 1 is connected to the remote repository, local repository of developer 2 is also connected to remote repository, and same for the developer 3. Now suppose developer 1 is working on a feature and it does some changes, it does some coding, and then it saves these changes and push those file to the remote repository. Now developer 2 is in need of that feature, but he has not worked on it. Developer 1 has worked on it. So what developer 2 will do? It will pull those files from this remote repositories to his own local system, and then he'll do some changes and then again save it and push to the remote repository. So I think you have understood the concept of this local and remote repository, which means the same repository is present, which is exact replica, and both are connected to each other. We'll see the connection that how those are connected by creating our own repository. So what we'll do, we'll try to open GitHub in our Chrome and we'll search for GitHub. This will give us the first link. We'll open it, and since I've created my account here, so what I'll do a sign in. So this is my email ID through which I can sign in, and this is my password which is not visible. So I'll sign in into my GitHub account, and you can see these are the different repositories those are present here. So you can see my chess game, Java, these to-do app in Angular 4 stories. These all repositories are what? These are remote repositories. Now if I want to show you the chess game Java, you can see here that these files are present, that is board.java, game.java, player.java and pieces.java. So as I have told you what that, I'll show you the slide, that repository is a place where files and folders are stored. So what we are doing, we are storing our files and we are storing our what? Folders. So this is a remote repository because it is present on some remote server. Now what we'll do, we'll try to clone this repository. So we'll go here, what? We'll this one and we'll control C it. So this is the clone for clone with HTTPS. So this is the clone link, or you can copy this also. So I'll just copy the link and I'll go to my Linux system. So this is my Linux system, and you can see here, this is a CentOS system and Git is present here. If I type Git, then Git is installed. So what I'll do clear screen and I'll try to clone the repository. So you can see here, this is Git clone and the path of the or the link of that particular repository. So what I'll do, I'll hit enter and this will try to clone my chess game. Now you will see, if I do a ls, you can see the chess game Java, which is the name of my repository here, chess game Java is present here. So if I'll go inside that chess game Java, you can see here, these are the different files that are present here. Now this is present on my local system. So currently this is a local repository, and this is present on the remote. So it is called remote repository. Now I have shown you a connection that this local repository is connected to my remote repository. So we'll see here how this is connected. So I'll say git remote minus v, and you can see here origin, this is the link. So this is for fetch, means you want to pull, and this is for push. So you want to push. So you can see here, if I type git remote minus v, which gives the address of the remote repository through which my local repository is connected. So now I think you have understood here that this repository, local repository, is connected to a remote repository. Now what I'll do, I'll come out of this folder and I'll create a new folder. So I'll type mkdir and I'll say I'll design a new game, and that will be Flappy Bird. So suppose I create a new directory, and this is my Flappy Bird. So I'll go inside this Flappy Bird, I'll do a clear up screen, and now what I'll do, I'll create a new file. So I'll type vim and test.js. So this is a new file that I have written, and I'll type a single line, and that is what, console.log, this is my game. So suppose this is some code, some random code that I have written, and if I do ls, then this test.js is present. Now what I'll do, I'll try to create my own local repository. So how to create my own local repository? I'll type the command git init, and this will say what? Initialize git empty git repository here. So this is a local repository. Now what happens if I say ls minus la, which will show me the hidden folder. This is A shows me the hidden folder. Then you can see here dot git is present, and when this dot git folder is present here, there are other files inside it which I am not going to show you. But if this particular folder is present, that means this is a git repository and this is a local git repository. Now if I show you this git remote minus v, this time, last time we have seen it, or if you want to see it again, I'll do here. So I'll come here, I'll go inside my cd chess game Java, and if I say git remote minus v, you can see I got a link of the remote repository through which it is connected. But this time if I'll do here in my local repository which I have created, this gives me nothing, which means this particular local repository is not connected to any other remote repository. So there are some ways to connect it by typing the command git remote add origin, which we'll see in some other videos of my Git. And because this video was only to understand about what is local and what is remote repository. So hope you like this video. If you like my channel, please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, then please share with other developers and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.